Y2 News, first at 4.
How widespread is identity theft here in the U.S.? One scientist estimates 60 to 80% of American Social Security numbers have now been hacked.
And Jeff Barn reports there is no quick fix. In fact, for most of us, there's no solution at all. He's watching out for you.
Picture thieves rummaging through the homes of as many as 260 million Americans and stealing their valuables. That's the estimated scope of identity theft right now in the United States.
It's outrageous.
Cyber thieves focus in nines, as in those nine numbers printed on every Social Security card.
And what makes identity theft possible is access to the Social Security number.
Once those Social Security numbers are stolen, victims are likely to never again feel secure. At any time, it means bank accounts can be unlocked, medical records seized, new credit cards opened, loans taken out, and fraudulent tax returns filed.
I'm steaming. I would like to do something about it.
Christine Robinson's identity was among the 21.5 million hacked from the Federal Office of Personnel Management in 2014.
What am I going to do personally to hold the federal government accountable?
The Social Security Administration seldom issues replacement numbers. The requirements are so stringent that the administration approved less than 300 requests last year. SSA declined our request for an interview, but based on its policies, new numbers are not given out just because a Social Security card is stolen. The administration says fears based on future misuse of a card is not enough of a reason to assign another one.
I certainly don't think the federal government can take the attitude, well, this is going to happen and people have to get used to it.
There should be stronger laws about the misuse of a Social Security number and stronger protections as far as cyber attacks.
Cyber thieves hacked more than 24 businesses, healthcare facilities, schools, and government offices, including the IRS. And that was in just the first 6 weeks of 2016, according to the Privacy Rights Clearinghouse. In Washington, I'm Jeff Barn reporting.
And this will make you feel even better. Even if you get a new number, it doesn't necessarily mean that you're secure again, because many businesses and institutions keep the old number on file and will link it to the new Social Security card.